तुम्हारे घर जाने का।
मैडम पीछे कैमरा
अरे छोड़ो ना यार, तुम खुद सोचना चाहिए, बार बार बोल रहे हो। छोड़ो ना यार, ध्यान नहीं।
बेस्ड अराउंड द पार्टीशन, टाइम इन इंडिया। I think it's delightfully absurd, delightfully pungent,
delightfully.
I'm wanting to make it as a feature film for a while, but because it's such a four-page story, converting it into a two-hour film would have really stretched you beyond the point. So when
sir, can you please use the mic? Sorry.
Do you need it?
You just need to capture on TV.
Yeah. It's good. It's good. Yes. So when ZTV actually came up with this Zindagi,
Z5,
it was Zindagi channel earlier. When they came up with this 1 hour film slot, I thought, yeah, that's the first thing that came to mind, because primarily they were actually doing a wonderful experiment of having six Indian filmmakers and six Pakistani filmmakers making a package of films. That itself told me the idea, basically. I think film is a wonderful medium to bridge these divides. And Tovar Dekh Singh is just the right kind of a film to be made under this kind of a banner. So it has been quite an experience making this film. Believe it or not, this 1 hour film we shot within a period of 10 days on a budget which was non-existent. And we all worked round the clock, almost 24 hours a day to make this happen. I hope that doesn't show in the film. And with these two great actors, there was hardly anything to worry about. And both of them have carried the film on their shoulders. Tovar Dekh Singh, and the moment I saw him, he had a beard this long. And when I saw that beard, I said, there's nobody else, that you have to do it. Because with that kind of a beard, he was almost looking the role of a madman. On the other hand, what we invented in the film was the character of Manto himself, the writer. And Manto was a maverick writer of his time, and we placed him in the mental asylum as a new warden of the place. Manto. And I feel the film should not be spoken about, it should be seen. So that's as short as I can keep it. Pankaj?
A wonderful experience working on the project. I've always loved working with Ketan. We've done a project earlier together, unfortunately just one before we did Tovar Dekh Singh. And he's a very fine director, and I look forward to working with him as and when possible, as and when he decides to say so and do so. It was a pleasure working with him always.
आप लोगों का ज़्यादा समय न लेते हुए
मैं सिर्फ ये कहना चाहूँगा कि फॉर एन एक्टर लाइक मी टू बी वर्किंग विद केतन वाज अ ड्रीम कम ट्रू एंड पंकज जी वाज नथिंग लेस देन अ बोनस देन केतन टोल्ड मी दैट पंकज जी हैज एग्रीड टू डू द रोल स्लीपलेस नाइट्स गेम I didn't know how to, because we had read the script a couple of times and I still couldn't wrap my head around as to how an actor would play this madman rather than just saying the lines. And when I saw Pankaji at work, it was, you know, an institution in itself. Everybody, not just me, everybody was just spellbound looking at Pankaji, and that's the reason he's the actor that he is. And I just want to take this opportunity to both of you, Ketan, for giving me this opportunity, and Pankaji, it was a sheer delight, and I can't thank you enough. Thank you very much. I hope you enjoyed the film, and I think you should start the film now.
Yes.
Yeah.
So, questions?
इस फिल्म में आपने मेन बेसिकली पंजाबी कल्चर पे वो आपको कुछ तकलीफ हुई बनाने में, कुछ ज़्यादा रिसर्च किया आपने, बहुत अच्छी फिल्म बनाई और सबसे अच्छा काम किया, सबसे अच्छा काम किया वो पब्लिक तक कैसे पहुँचाएंगे आपको वर्षा दिया या कौन सी फिल्म है आपके हिसाब से?
ये फिल्म जो हमने शूट की वो चंडीगढ़ के पास एक बस्ती पठाना करके गाँव जिसने ये लोकेशन देखी, और लोकेशन हैड ए कैरेक्टर ऑफ इट्स ओन एंड इन माय माइंड आई कंबाइन द लोकेशन विद द स्पेस. That seemed like the right combination, and that's why we shot there. In the peak of summer, 45 degrees, 10 days of intense shooting, that's how this film happened. A nightmare as an experience, and an enthralling nightmare at that. Yes, it's a story of Punjab, but written in Urdu. And I think it's agnostic in that sense. Really speaking, it's a world story. Story of divisions, story of migration, story of human conditions. And it's a universal story told from the heart, controlled from the heart, as far as Minto is concerned. And I can assure you, as far as both of us are concerned, this story has been with us for such a long time. And it is one of the greatest stories of Urdu literature, and I think one of the greatest stories in the world. So it has been an incredible experience making this.
जी मेरे ख्याल में इससे बड़ी कहानी पार्टीशन या सेपरेशन पे लिखी नहीं गई है, यूं समझ लीजिए कि शायद मैंने पढ़ी नहीं, लेकिन जो कुछ भी मैंने पढ़ा है या जानकारी हासिल की, आई डोंट थिंक there's any story which is more valid, more questioning than this particular story written by Manto, which is only 3.5 pages. One starts wondering through the story as to who is mad, whether those people who decided the partition of India were mad really, and whether all of them are a part of this asylum and we are only showing this asylum. What is the mindset of these people who are deciding to even divide the madmen of the world? So I mean, it raises a lot of questions that, and it has been very close to my heart. I relate to this story greatly, and when Ketan sort of came up with this idea, I just jumped at him, and I needed to be a part of this story. It was an inner call for me that I had to be a part of it. When you asked about the commercial release of this, I think Z5 is already sort of releasing it, which is a wonderful thing for us. And I hope that many people see it. I'm told that the trailer has got some good hits and all that, some good number. They talk in these numbers these days, which I'm not very aware of. But I'm happy that
if a lot of people are relating to the trailer, we hope that they will also see the film. And ये उन बातों में से और उन कहानियों में से है जो हर एक के दिल में बसनी चाहिए, हर एक के घर में पहुंचनी चाहिए, हर एक को सोचने में मजबूर करनी चाहिए और लोगों को इस पर विचार करना चाहिए, हिस्टोरिकल कॉन्टेक्स्ट में भी और मौजूदा कॉन्टेक्स्ट में।
And it's a very cliche question, I'm sure it will come across very cliche, but the moment, the first scene when you walked out from the jail and you established your character by your walk, I'm just curious, probably it will be my life's answer if you'll give me that, what was the homework, how you thought of this madman, that what the body language, how you worked on it, that is, if you can just give some insight on it.
I think it's been a while that we did this film, yes. But primarily whatever comes to you comes from the text, whatever script that Ketan had written and the story that we read originally, everything comes from there, because there's a reference of the fact that the man has not sat down for 10 years, which sort of, we discussed it ideally, frankly speaking, I should have had such big thighs, you know, which was not physically possible for us to do, so we discussed and tried to do some kind of, you know, wrapping of cloths and bandages, etc., so that the thighs appear a little big and gives a sense of a guy who has actually not sat for those many years. So one sort of imagined as to if a person has actually not sat for 10 years, what would his walk be like? So those were discussions that we had, and that is something that I enjoy about Ketan, because there is one of very few directors, allow me to say, who understands acting and who understands what a character is all about. So it was wonderful having those talks and discussions with him and arriving at conclusions together, which was even more delightful for him.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you.
See, what is challenging, really speaking, in terms of characterization of this character, the fact is that it's an absurd character. 15 saal tak jo koi baitha nahi hai, na kuch hua hai, it's an exaggeration beyond anything that you can actually work out. And to make it convincing is a challenge for any actor in the world. And I'm so grateful for that Pankaj ji actually took up the challenge and gave me the joy of my life in terms of working with him. Thank you, Pankaj.
Well done, well done.
मेरा सवाल मंटो के लिए है, की तरफ से है कि एक मंटो हम सभी जानते हैं एक महान लेखक हैं, रह चुके हैं, तो एक दौर था जब उनकी रचनाओं को काफी ज्यादा लोगों ने नहीं पहचाना और उनका बहिष्कार भी बड़े पैमाने पे हुआ एक दौर में, फिर अचानक से एक दौर भी आया है जब अब सभी का ध्यान उनकी तरफ आकर्षित हुआ है और उनकी फिल्में बन रही है, उनके अफसाने पढ़े जा रहे हैं, अफसांचे पढ़े जा रहे हैं, तो आप क्या ऐसा क्या वजह हो सकती है इसके पीछे कि अचानक से मंटो एक लाइमलाइट में आ रहे हैं और आज अचानक से लोग एक बड़े महान लेखक को पहचान पा रहे हैं और उन पर ध्यान जा रहा है?
I'm sure his writings are resonating today in the conditions that the country today. And this is not just a story about India and Pakistan, this is a story of human condition.
Absolutely.
And therefore, I'm sure Manto was reviled in his time, but he was hated in his times. He was criticized vociferously, almost violently at times. But he was, even in his lifetime, recognized as a great writer. And we understand why upar di gurgurdi bejana di mungi dal di latin to come up with this line in 1949-50 or whatever it was, something like this, when this story was written. I mean, this is the beginning of absurd literature in India, and absurd literature which is so meaningful, which is so perceptive, which is so direct, which is so mind-blowing is what great literature is about, and that's what fascinates us about this story.
See, to a part of your question, that
how is it that people are becoming self-believing? One of the reasons I think is communication, that the means of communication have increased. I mean, earlier there were only books. Today, those books are talked about. There are more talk shows. There are things available on computers, on your mobiles, in terms of world literature, in terms of various things. There are various kinds of means and ways by which these things are reaching out to the youngster of today. So I would say that those who are interested in actually knowing about world literature, dig up literature in every language. And today they have a way of reaching out to it because of various other mediums which have come up. So probably you're sitting over here and talking about this just now. I'm sure that there are other places where people do literary talks and literary evenings, etc., where this must already be existing since they were written. We are becoming more aware of them because of the media.
नहीं ये सब एक वक्त के लिए उसे अश्लील करार दिया गया था उनकी रचनाओं को, तो ऐसा मैं क्या हम ऐसा मान सकते हैं कि सब्जेक्ट को लेकर के हम लोग कुछ ज्यादा, हमारे एक्सेप्टेंस लेवल बढ़ चुका है पहले से? पहले उन्हें जो जिन सब्जेक्ट को स्वीकार नहीं किया जा रहा था वो हम अब स्वीकार करने लगे हैं, हमारा समाज और पाठक वर्ग जो भी है वो स्वीकार करने लगे हैं।
मुझे लगता है स्वीकार तो तब भी किया जाता था, लेकिन कुछ ऐसा महसूस होता था कि पब्लिकली इस बात को ना कहा जाए। लेकिन आज का यंगस्टर क्योंकि बहुत ज़्यादा एक्सपोज्ड है टू एवरीथिंग, एक्सपोज्ड के मानी यहाँ पे है कि टू एवरीथिंग दैट इज हैपनिंग वर्ल्ड ओवर, तो जिसकी वजह से इस बात को छोटा या बड़ा नहीं माना जाता है कि अगर एक अच्छी कहानी लिखी गई है जिसका जो भी लहजा रहा हो उस कहानी को आप पढ़ें और उसका सुख हासिल करें और उसकी रियलिटी में जाएं। और अच्छे लेखन की एक सबसे बड़ी पहचान ये होती है कि वो अपने ज़माने की, अपने टाइम की रियलिटी को रिफ्लेक्ट करता है। तो रियलिटी भले किसी समय पे इंसान को अश्लील लगती हो, लेकिन उसके अंदर एक रियलिटी तो एग्जिस्ट करती है ना भाई। अगर वो एग्जिस्ट करती है तो उसको पढ़ के, सुन के, देख के आप अगर अपने अंदर कोई तब्दीली ला सकते हैं या अपने आसपास के समाज के अंदर कुछ तब्दीली ला सकते हैं तो बहुत मुबारकबाद और बहुत बड़ी बात है कि आजकल यंगस्टर अगर ऐसे सोचता है।
हाय सर, माय सेल्फ हां सर, टोवा टीक सिंह पढ़े हुए सर का कैरेक्टर, उसमें सब कुछ है, लेकिन जब आप मंटो का कैरेक्टर डेवलप कर रहे थे तो कैसे आपने उसको अप्रोच किया कि इसको हेड बनाते हैं? मे बी कैन बी अ विजिटर और कुछ भी हो सकता था, लेकिन उसको किस तरह से, मतलब बिकॉज मंटो को सूट पैंट में देख के उस तरह से देख के थोड़ा, बिकॉज मंटो का जो मेरे दिमाग में इमेज है, इट्स लाइक मुझे नहीं लगता कि उधर अगर बैठा तो एक घंटे इधर ही बैठा रहेगा। उसको इस तरह से देखना, वो पूरी रात उधर वो कर रहा है, साइलम लोगों को एक्सचेंज कर रहा है, इतना पेशेंस, इतना मतलब धैर्य वाला मुझे लगता नहीं, उनकी राइटिंग को भी देख के, उनके कैरेक्टर्स को भी देख के, और जिस तरह से आपने खोल दो कहानी को इसमें लेके आए वो बहुत ब्यूटीफुल था सर, उसका जो रेफरेंस था। बट मंटो को इतना ज्यादा, इतना गवर्नमेंट ऑफिशियल बना देना अपने आप में एक बहुत ही ऐसा अलग सा एक्सपीरियंस है
देखना।
But can you like conceive him in your brain कि वो इतना इस तरह के भी मंटो का भी हो सकते हैं, इतना ज़्यादा संजीदा?
मंटो को हम लोग सिर्फ उसकी कहानियों के द्वारा जानते हैं, और and finally his name is Siddharth Hasan Manto. So primarily it is just an association that one was trying to trigger with Manto, saying he is a narrator of the story. So he is the narrator. Who is the narrator for, in my mind? It's Manto who is the narrator. So that's why this association. And it's a 3.5-page story. To stretch it to an hour-long story, we had to invent new characters. And I thought this was the best way of going.
My only thing is ki मैं कभी ऐसे इमेजिन नहीं कर सकता हूँ मंटो की, फैज साहब आई कैन स्टिल इमेजिन कि वो डिप्लोमेट हो सकते हैं, बट मंटो इज
बुले शाह को बड़ा अच्छा अकोमोडेट किया, किसी का आइडिया था कैसा था?
इन अ सेंस दिस इज अ सूफी स्टोरी, इफ यू लुक एट इट इन द स्पिरिट, and Bulle Shah is one of the greatest Sufi poets of his time, and it's इंटीग्रल टू पंजाब और कैसे किया वही बंदा वहां पे वन ऑफ द एक्टर्स वाज सिंगिंग इट वन डे and I just heard it and the sound was so perfect that we actually this is actually recorded on the set the man singing there himself it is not background score at all so we just used that those songs and it was an instant spontaneous decision and I think it worked very very well
thank you
supposed to come on where
this was Since this was produced by Zindagi TV, we knew that it was going to come on television. Though the, there was some kind of an indication that they will try and release it theatrically as well as packaged films in one slot kind of a thing. Unfortunately, when the films got ready, and actually, like Toba Tek Singh. These 12 filmmakers, 6 from India, 6 from Pakistan, we met in Amritsar, we went to Wagah border, the photographs were taken, and then we did not get the visa to go to Pakistan, when we were supposed to. So we also all felt like Toba Tek Singh. So, yeah, that's how it is. We are all Toba Tek Singhs, whether we like it or not. Caught in no man's land at this point of time. And I think the full story is still so many.
Ketan, what do you think that would have been better, a theatrical release, because the reach would have been wider?
As a filmmaker, you always want to see your film on a big screen, larger than life. In the digital age, I think this will still reach out to as many people as possible. And you see, when these films were made, everyone was gung-ho about India-Pakistan friendship, Manmohi and all that was going on. By the time the films were completed, the relations had soured completely. And they haven't improved since. So that was one of the reasons why the films were not really... It was supposed to be a kind of a gesture where the films will travel all across Pakistan and all across India and giving out a message of peace and harmony. Unfortunately, that didn't happen because of the real politics.
Thank you so much. What we wanted to do for our viewers and our subscribers is that bring this film festival on digital platform, which gives you even a wider reach. I guess somebody asked on big screen. Today, I mean, digital penetration is going far ahead. And we want everybody at your convenience to watch these movies. So log on to Z5 and watch 12 movies every Friday on the platform. Thank you.